we would like to respect to my director Basu and Shri Samna, myself, and Coach Amigo, everybody. Okay? Yeah. Then we have a great honor that you can be standing here for presentation about the practical border defense today. Okay? And before we are going to presentation, we would like to say thank you to my supervisor. Yeah, that guide us, yeah, and invite us with our practical camp. Okay, thank you. Okay, so now please allow me for introduction my member group. My name is Tumkarat. My name is Yo.
My name is Tom Roya.
My name is
Okay, thank you. Yes. Okay. In here. Okay. For me, it's more about introduction, and in here we help to find some things that we have already to learn in the before. Yeah. And I'm going to briefly for you with the subject that we have already to learn. Then the first subject that we learn in the year 4, teaching methodology. Okay, what is the teaching methodology? Teaching methodology is the method of the teaching. Yeah, that we study about the method of teaching. And combine all possible technique, activity to teach students to effectively. So after we study about the method teaching methodology, we came to teacher, or we know that how to control the class, how to teach students. Yeah. Come from teaching methodology subject. Yes. Okay. About the second. Second is apply logistics. Okay, apply logistics. Apply logistics is the subject that we have to learn with the language. Yeah. The language structure. Language structure. We know about history of the language, like as the vocabulary or such as the language, the history language. So we study of linguistics, we know about history of the language or history of the vocabulary, and we use the vocabulary or the language into regular living. We study of linguistics. And third, we study about the foundation education. What is the foundation education? Foundation education is the subject that we learn with origin, right? Origin education. We know about system education, we know about process education, and we know about what happened in the education. When we study this subject, we know about how to apply education to our society. Yeah, and how to apply the system education to present our family. That we study with a foundation education. Okay, and four, translation and interpreting. Translation and interpreting is a subject that we learn with how to be a good translator or how to be interpreter. Okay, so we know that how can we change to solve level 2 target language, right? By speak or by write. And after we study the fresh translation and interpreting, we can interpreter or we can translator. This is the subject, translation and interpreting. And the last, research methodology. Research methodology is the subject that we learn with find about data or the collect data or find about information. Yeah. We know that how can we find document or we research. Yeah. This subject is we students spend a lot of time for find about information or find on the time. So we know about the new knowledge come from the research methodology. So all of this investment we have a five subjects that we learn in the gym form. The first teaching methodology, and third, applied logistics, Yeah. Okay. So we have second of logistic and second foundation education and the whole translation and interpreting and research methodology in practice. So all five of my subject is to be studied in the form. And thank you for my point and let me to Ms. Gina and she is for me. Lesson plan. Whiteboard, chair arrangement, and well-prepared, and voice. And for using whiteboard, as you are a teacher, you have to know how to use the whiteboard. When you go to teach in one class, you have to know using whiteboard, like you divide the whiteboard into two parts. And about your letter, you should write big enough, do not write too small. Make sure that your student can see your letter clear. For chair arrangement and well prepared, you have to think about your class. In your class, you should prepare the table or your chair. Your student should be sitting in order. Don't let your student sit in messy or just sit somewhere or just leave some space in it. That is not good. And for voice, also you have to think about your class, whether it's big or small. If your class is too big, you have to speak loudly to make sure that the students sit at the back, they hear your voice. Next slide, please. According to my teaching practicum and my observe, I can see that some point to be improved, like lack of time management, give more clear instruction. Like lack of time management. Sometimes, some training, while I do observe, I can see that they spend much time with students, they play game, or they have another student. So they forgot to check the voice, that's why they lack of time management. And give more clear instruction. For me, myself, when I'm going to teach, I just speak too fast, so that's why my student cannot catch all my presentation or my explanation. What about resolution of this problem? For lack of time management, you have to set time arrangement and you have to follow lesson plan. Whatever they have planned in your lesson, you have to follow. And preparation. Preparation, you have to prepare some material related to your lesson or lesson plan. You should make it clear. And what about your lesson? Should be, you have to understand all the points. When you go to teach, you have to explain them clearly about that. So I just want to, before I finish, I just want to sum up my point. What is classroom management? And classroom management, including using a whiteboard, voice, or gesture, body language, or chair arrangement. And I just want to share to all of you about my experience. For me, before I'm going to teach, I just prepare myself, like well prepared, even though my uniform. And during class, before I teach, I set the rule and explain to them and give punishment to them when they do wrong. That is my experience. So that's all for my point. So let's move to Ms. Renita. Thank you.
And for then Jack Rose not communicative at all, be communicative at all between students and students. Okay? Besides in teaching approach, besides the approach in teaching, we have to master in teaching grammar. That's right, in teaching grammar. The first is inductive methods. Inductive methods mean teacher take take student from general to specific. That teacher starting with give the example and after give the form. Example teacher around teacher think about the grammar passing form. But teacher sometimes teacher just write the sentence on the whiteboard and let the student to find the function as like the subject or verb or object and write the form on the whiteboard. And the second point is deductive methods. Deductive methods means the teacher take the student from specific to general. Specific to general, the teacher will give student the form and after that the teacher ask student and after that the teacher ask student give the example. Example, the teacher think about the passing form, the teacher write the form on the whiteboard and let the student to find the example or write the example that related to the form on the whiteboard. Yes. Before I finish my point, I want to sum up my point. The first, my point is methodology. It has two kinds. The first is student-centered approach, or CLC, and the second point is teacher-centered approach, or GTM. And for the teaching grammar, we have two points also. The first is inductive method, and the second is deductive method.
I will present you about the conclusion. After the my group member they my group member presented about the four main points already. I will conclude all the four main points that they already presented. There have four main points they presented already. The first talk about the conclusion. The conclusion is talk about the five subject, the importance of five subject that we already learned in the year four semester one and semester two, we just only learned about four subjects. And the importance of five subject that we learned in year four semester one, what we get from it, and what all of them that teach us as like the techniques to teach the student activity, how to use the language learning, the meanings of language, how to do research, how to collect the data, and how to learn about the background of the education, system education, and learn about the many things that we learn. And the second point, talk about the lesson plan. During the practicum, we use the lesson plan for the student and the trainee in experience for teaching. We use like lesson plan is the guideline for the new teacher or new trainee or inexperienced teacher to use the map for them to use the thing, what activity we do next, what that activity that we improve in the class. And the second point about the two kinds of lesson plans. As my member Rob mentioned it already, the lesson plan it has many, many kinds, but we only mentioned only two kinds in the lesson plan. It has PPP and POS. PPP, the aim of PPP is to introduce the new target language. And aim of POS is to practice the new target language. And the third talk about the understanding about the lesson plan. Through the practicum, it already the understanding about the lesson plan that lesson plan that divide three parts: before practice, during practice, and after practice. We understand all of step and point B and rule is also for the middle part. And for the third is classroom management. Classroom management, we talk about the meaning of classroom management, that how to control the student, how to control the class, how to use the Bible, how to use voice in the class big, loudly enough. And point B rule that we found through we are teaching practicum. And we found that the resolution of what we met during the practice. And the fourth, talk about the methodology. The methodology is a popular methodology, like popular approach for teaching. We have two kinds of popular teaching methodology approach, that student-centered approach, it's called CLT, it means communicative language teaching. And the third thing talk about, and the next talk about the teacher-centered approach that we call GTM. GTM, it means grammar translation method. And the last talk about the kinds of teaching grammar. We have two kinds for teaching grammar. We teach from inductive method. We teach inductive method or we teach deductive method, depend on what your lesson that you took before you go into teach, which one that you need to conduct in the class. And the next slide. And the next slide talk about the suggestion and recommendation. We really, like we can say, the school should provide more training to train many times than we do the practical time that we agree or we assume it already. Because we understand it a little and we understand just a little bit in classroom. Not like we can say, not become the professional teacher, not we understand not at all. We need to try to practice more than we do it now. We have two times or three times that to teach the class. We want, our group want to teach more time than this to practice more. And the third, we suggest and we recommend, like we support and we agree with this program that make all the students in departments of English education for teaching, like you can say, the student English in department, like after they finish this, we graduate, we can use the real practice and get experience and become a professional teacher. We understanding the student feeling and understanding the teacher feeling during the teaching. And we want to suggest them, the school. We want to suggest the school to keep this program to the next generation to build up their capacity after their capacity after they finish or graduate from this school. And thank you. And that's all for our group presentation, and let's come to the question.
Our teaching amount. It is my
on my teaching grant account. I have 2 points. First is I'm not sure about my lesson plan. When I'm prepared, I just say something that is related to lesson that I'm going to teach. But when I go to teach, I practice different from my lesson plan. And one more thing, the lesson that I'm going to teach at home, before I'm going to teach, I just read it, I just find out the problem, but when I'm going to teach, I just forgot some point and I'm feel nervous when I provide the lesson or provide the education to my student. That is my lack point and that is my difficulty.
Yes, for me, for the point of the teaching program, with the for me in the school, with the lesson plan and for the classroom in the I send the lesson plan all day, but when I teach, some point I cannot control the times. Yes, and when I teach some of the students, is the my teaching class, and I talk. And tell them not to do that, not to do that, not to do that, just press the telephone, play the Facebook or another thing else that I continue to learn about something like that.
So, teacher, I remember. Okay, for me, the form of practicum, so while the teaching for me is the first lesson. Lesson plan that I set already, so I set it already, and I prepare at my home. Yeah, and I expect that the student can be get control my lesson. But when I be in situation, some student it so busy and it call for control. Because I think that this is the first time for me that I can solve. Sorry, I can't teach them. Okay, and one more thing. Classroom, yeah. Some of the classroom, some student come late. So sometimes student don't understand what lesson that I teach first. So it's make some student unclear about my lesson.
But for me, I have the most important difficulty during my teaching program. The first about the lesson plan. Before I create the lesson plan, I must be understand the level of the student that they learn with me and the level of I am clear enough or strong enough with this subject. And for classroom management, sometimes classroom management, we can manage the student is like messy or which the techniques or the activity that we include in the class that we want to achieve their objective. So this is the difficulty for me. That's it for me.
Okay, thank you. Can you give me one of the questions? Okay, it's a link to your answer. I can say that most of you check the problem with lesson plan and classroom management. Right? So, okay, what are the factors that cause you cannot control your classroom while you are teaching? You got my point?
For me, the factor that I cannot control the class well, like some students, they try to like, we can say, share with the teacher, like before teacher give the instruction to them, they think that the age of the teacher and age of the student is the same. So some students think that I don't listen to him. So he is the same me. So sometimes they think that they don't listen to me and try to like reject what that I want to them to do, like assign them to do for like peer work or group work. Some students that they like we say they reject about the instruction that they give to them. And they ask the teacher, I don't understand what you mean.
they understand already, but they try to reject. They don't want to involve, like, you see that the eight of student, or the eight of teacher and student, are little bit like similar.
For lesson plan and classroom management. Lesson plan, I have set up it already at home and it look great and it just look nice. But when I go to real practice, I cannot control, I cannot follow my lesson plan because of I just spend much time with another student, discipline them when they didn't have, or they just when I have game, some games, but some game it take time to, so long, so that's why I cannot follow the lesson plan. And what about classroom management? Some students they think that the teacher knowledge is not better than him or not higher, so that's why they just look down, or they just sometimes they just don't listen, they disrupt another student in one class and they not properly in class. So this is the problem.
For me, I want to add along. Sometimes students have that short visit, they can spend a lot of time. And second is number of the time. The number of students of the time, it is more students that we cannot control. And second, student no cooperate with the teacher. That's all. Okay, for me, for the that the teacher cannot control the classroom management, because some of the student is the has the more members in the class, and some student is the come left, and the some student or when the teacher take some student don't listen, just talking with a friend with with friend in the class, so they don't listen to the teacher. If the teacher talk, they talk. So what is
So this is the problem for me. But for me